Okay, so in the last episode, we finished off our talent tree. I was just shy of it when trying to do a nightmare run, and then I decided to just kind of go through and get it via normal mode. And yeah, so we have it completed. So what I'm going to do now is kind of just bounce around. Usually in games like this, I like to max out a character and then, you know, play the next character, max them out. But unfortunately, yes, I say unfortunately, for people like me that like grind, the talent tree actually carries over for every character except the hero talents. Those ones I still have to grind out with a new set of juice, basically, a new set of essence. Now, each character has three achievements tied to them on Steam. There is the achievement for using their skill enough times, basically. So, like, I think pinning down enemies for 10,000 total seconds or whatever with Crown Prince's E ability was that one. Then there's also an achievement for... what was the other achievement? For winning with that character, so having a successful run, which is probably the most straightforward and easiest one. Least time-consuming one. And then the third achievement, which is the hardest one, is every character has a unique frame where you have to meet some sort of specific requirement. Like, for example, Crown Prince, we remember we needed to pin down an enemy for 10 consecutive seconds, which was actually a lot more difficult than it sounded. But I need to come to the decision of, do I just complete the hero talents and then play another character? Or do I try to get all three of the achievements? I think I want to at least do a successful run with every character and try to get their talents as well. But the framework can be a bonus for another time. Though some characters, from what I've seen about their frames, don't seem too bad. Lei Luo here, I believe his name is. I believe his frame requires you to just beat Nightmare difficulty using only a sniper rifle, which is very doable, I think, in solo. And another character over here, one of the DLC characters, Lee, I believe her name is, her special one, I think, is the most straightforward. I don't know how difficult, but it's just to beat a boss using only her skill. That's it. Don't use any weapons or have a teammate help you or anything. You just have to beat a boss with her skill. And I would imagine that that's possible to do even in the very first boss stage, even if it's a little bit grindy and spongy. I don't know, because I've never used her. I just know that she casts fire magic, I believe. But yeah, so yay, that's that. Now, it obviously comes down to, who do I want to play next? Well, I think, as much as there's a few, there's definitely some essence I need to earn to unlock two of the characters from the base game. But of the other characters available, I think the two that I want to go to next are either going to be Qing Yan or Lei Luo, because these two characters, first of all, there are some additional achievements that I think I could get easily with this guy, that being melee kills, because I don't have that yet. And of course, this one, because I already know I love rifle gameplay in this, and so having a character that kind of revolves entirely around it would be a lot of fun. Let's see. Let me look at you. So the only experience I have with a couple of these characters are just basically Finn and or with Tao when Aki was playing. So that's it. But let's see. So your main skill is to leap, which leaps forward with a hard kick, dealing 500 damage to all enemies within. So it's basically just an AoE attack. Each hit can recover 20% of armor. And then cleave, which is basically his grenade, so to speak, is recklessly. Cleave recklessly and deal 500 damage to the enemies within a fan shape. So I don't know if that's a melee strike or if it actually flies off into distance, whatever. He's a skilled martial artist who moves like the wind and is as elusive as the shadows. Unlike others, he dislikes alchemy and shields and instead indulges in close quarters combat and armor. With his martial arts prowess, he leaps into the fray and to cleave enemies. With that being said, he also enjoys the smoke and sounds of a shotgun. Well, of course, if he's close quarters, that would make sense. I think we'll play as this character next, just because, like I said, there's some things that I want to get with him. So if we open up my achievements list here, we can see that I'm very close to getting death proof, which just requires me to die 6 more times. But for this character, of course, we need to beat a game with him right here. That'll be easy enough to do. We just have to finish a game. That's it. But what is his special ability? That's what I need to see. So, where is it? God damn. Oh, right here. Okay, so we have to kill 5 enemies in a single leap. So basically use this skill and kill 5 enemies 50 times. I think that might not be too bad to do with all the big groups, or like the beetles, or what other little groups of small, easy to kill enemies. I think that'd be the most useful. It's just time consuming, basically. Now his special thing, I don't actually know what you have to do with his frame. I believe it's this here. Yeah, we need to get 3,000 stacks of easy kill in a single run, and I don't actually know what that is. So I guess we'll just have to learn how he plays and see. Oh, here, actually, I can look at his ascensions right now. So he's got a blue, red, and yellow. Oh, that's a new color for me. orange, I guess, not yellow. So it looks like one... Let's see, what is over here? Steel armor. Oh my god, is there really always been these many ascensions? There's 6 different ascensions for each color palette? Frick, dude. I didn't realize. What? Is that how it was for this guy, too? Yeah, I guess there was. Dang. Really did not realize that. Okay, well, then, let's see here. What is this 0? Oh, I think that's how many talents I have for him specifically. So his ascension... Well, I don't have to read these now. I could just decide on it in-game. But it looks like Fleeting Scud enhances jump attack. Combat expertise will enhance... It looks like damage at close range and stuff. And then Fatal Wings will enhance the hack attack, whatever that means. Oh, cleave damage and stuff. Okay. And AoE increase. Alright, well, this is my first time playing another character in this game, so this is going to be entirely new. Compared to Crown Prince, he has a bit more HP, a bit less in the way of his shield, which is armor now, but his move speed is a bit higher. So there's that. And it looks like we'll be leveling up his talents as we go, and that's the only way I think that we can raise our overall talent level, which is 143 right now, and I believe it's only 143 because of the 5 we got for Crown Prince. So yeah, every time there's a new character added, I guess that means there's a new max level that you can go to for talents. All right, hero, switch, deploy, bam, here we go. So I'm going to try to go for like a melee build, I think, for starters, and we'll play on Elite. Let's see, new adventure. Oh, actually, is Daily Challenge that started yet? New one? No, an hour and a half. Okay, so we've got a new one of those coming up at some point here. Okay, new adventure. And let's switch it to Elite, and let's give it a whirl. Now, I am going to stop and have a bite to eat because I'm very hungry. It's somewhere halfway through this because I was too impatient to wait. And I would like to get some stuff going. Well, I don't see. I'll go with the Star Ring, I guess, for right now. So here's my new hands. Oh, he sounds like a guy. He doesn't really sound kind of like he doesn't sound at all what I was expecting. So this, okay, yeah. So that's like basically a melee strike. His Q ability. Okay, well, we're gonna have to get used to the new character then here. Oops, that was E. I'm already trying to press his Q. Yeah, okay, see, that didn't do anything. Okay, so it can be... Oh, you can kind of spam it. I see. Alright. It's gonna take some getting used to. I think it'll be better once I have a sword. Oh boy, here we go. So minus 50% damage taken for 2 seconds after hitting an enemy or breaking an object with leap, plus 20% damage on the enemy for the current and next 4 hits with cleave. So the more I spam it, the more it does. 300 cleave base damage for 6 seconds upon defeating the enemy. Recover 40% of your armor after hitting an enemy with leap, or 20% if you do not hit any targets. Oh, I'll take that for right now. I have no idea what I want to prioritize yet. That remains to be seen, since I have no idea what kind of playstyle I like to go here. I'm just going to try to work on melee, because that's kind of what he seems to be like. Well, let's see. Okay, so it didn't kill really anybody there. It just killed the beetles, not the big guys. The shot chance for each HP missing. It's not too bad, not too shabby. Wait, what? Oh crap, I went the wrong way here apparently. I have to remember E is the ability. No, right, Q is the other one. Damn it, I'm actually getting all my buttons messed up here. Maybe I should change. I wonder if I should change it. And you can change it, right? Let me see, settings, mouse and keyboard. Oh, you can, okay. I might actually mess around with that. I mean, it'll take some getting used to, but I might change it to stuff I'm a little bit more familiar with, because I'm mispressing of these buttons while I'm trying to do this. Like, I don't know, Q is fine. I think that Q should be better for the ability, but... Okay. I need a sword really bad. Killing an enemy grants extra coppers, or do we want hidden transaction? You know what, I'm gonna go with hidden transaction. Extra coppers might actually be better, but... Okay, there's magic feathers. Oh, that's what my grenade is, basically. It's like, what the fuck are these? See, I'm pressing Q to try and use my ability. A bow. You know, how about I take this quick? Increase my cleave capacity. Restore one use upon killing an enemy. Each hit with cleave restores 10 armor and reduces my cooldown. And then we got this shit. Gain one stack of Nova Shockwave for hitting an enemy with a shot. Each stack plus one armor for 9 seconds. When your armor breaks, deal damage to nearby enemies equal to 50 times. Probably just go with this then, I guess. I don't know. I don't really know how I like to play him right now. No, I think this should be good as is. Here we go. This is it. There we go. So that should be 1 out of 50 right there. So whenever I see groups of small enemies like that, or if I beef up my ability enough. Our first elite. Okay, I'm getting kind of tired of fighting this guy here, to be honest. Especially considering I literally cannot... I cannot see him until he... looks at me. This is going to be really tedious, because now I can't lock enemies down. Oh, look, it's our good old friend. Crap. Oh, this is gonna be tough. This is gonna be tough getting used to a new one. But I think once I have a sword, everything will go pretty well. Move speed after using dash, that's pretty good. I have to remember, I don't want to look at these and think, oh yeah, this might help out my, you know, bondage ability. I have to remember that I'm playing a new character here. Oh, I'm out of cleave. Okay, shit. Mr. Peddler, do you have something for me? No. This lucky shot chance. You know what? I'm gonna buy this. Because if this is how, oh crap, is it, I got, oh, poor accuracy, it doesn't look like it. Lucky shot chance and fully charged. Okay. Oh, hold on. Bam, there's another one. Take that, actually. Give money or random scroll. I'll take a random scroll. Deal lightning damage. Damn it. I pressed Q to use my ability, and that was the wrong one. I don't know how I'm getting so confused here. So I'm definitely probably going to have to mess around and change that. Okay, cleave. So orange is cleave, red is for like close quarters combat, and blue is for my skill. Yeah, I'll go ahead and do this. This will actually give me a bit more AoE. Not being able to freeze enemies, that's going to take some getting used to. Another scroll, huh? Get one random ammo every time I move. Alright, I'll take it. Alright, I died. Okay. that was not a good start. I'm going to go ahead and go into the settings menu and change some of these ability things around, because I think that might help me in the long run, because I keep pressing the wrong buttons when I want to use his skill, for example. We can actually already afford his first thing, though. If leap does not hit any enemies, the cooldown is reduced by 50%. I'll go ahead and take that. There we go. That is raising my talent. Nice. Okay. So the only other thing to use essence for, I think, is either the high difficulty or spiritual assault, I think, uses it. I don't know. I just see that everything costs it there, but also unlocking the other characters as well. Okay. So that's a nice buff for us. Now let me go back and let me go into settings and let's go mouse keyboard. Let me think about this quick. Everything else I think works perfectly fine. I don't know why that's a comma. Weapon last used. Primary skill, secondary skill. These are the two things I need. Shift is fine for dash. I'm fine with just about everything else. F in is interact. Honestly, I almost want to... I'm used to F, but I mean, E would also be really good too. And F would be good as my... let me see. So primary skill, I want this to be Q. Now my mouse has disappeared. What the fuck? Hello? What? Hold on a minute.